हेलो गाइस, हाउ यू ऑल? ग्रीटिंग फ्रॉम मिस्टर आर. कैसे हैं आप सभी? आई एम होपिंग दैट यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. सो टुडे बेसिकली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट, प्री टेस्ट फॉर एग्जीक्यूटिव एंड प्रोफेशनल स्टूडेंट. ओके, हाउ इट विल बी कंप्लीटेड एंड हु नीड्स टू कंप्लीट, हु दोज आर स्टूडेंट नीड्स टू कंप्लीट दिस प्री टेस्ट एंड प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट. सो वी कंप्लीट, वी विल गो विद दिस कंप्लीट कन्फ्यूजन विच यू हैव इन योर हेड. And also we will go some a few cues, some frequently asked question as well. Okay. So first of all, the new syllabus student, every student who is in the new syllabus, which is 2017 syllabus, are required to complete their pre-examination test. Okay. If you are shifting your old syllabus to the new syllabus, okay, you are giving your June session, any session you are giving in for the future. Before enrolling or before giving your examination, you have to complete your pre-test. Okay, institute have some guidelines that you need to complete your pre-test for executive and professional student before filling your examination form. Okay, either you won't be able to fill your examination form for upcoming stages. All right. In some cases, institute have also given the option that you just fill the examination form and clear your pre-test or pre-examination test before sitting in the examination center at examination hall, right? So बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट को जो प्रॉब्लम था दैट कि जो है कौन कौन से स्टूडेंट को प्री एग्जामिनेशन की जरूरत है. सो जो भी सिलेबस 2017 वाले में है, जो भी स्टूडेंट हैं, उनको अपना प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट पास आउट करना पड़ेगा. अगर वो अगर कोई ओल्ड सिलेबस का बच्चा है, ओल्ड सिलेबस से न्यू सिलेबस में आता है, तो भी जो है उसको प्री टेस्ट देना पड़ेगा. ठीक है, इसमें जो है आपको एग्जाम्पशन के लिए भी कुछ सर्टेन पेपर देने होते हैं. अगर आपको प्री टेस्ट एग्जाम्पशन करना है तो उसके लिए भी जो है कुछ सर्टेन पेपर्स होते हैं, उसके बारे में भी हम बात करेंगे आगे चल करके. उससे पहले जान लेते हैं कि आपको इसको एक्सेस कैसे करना है. ठीक है, सो अगर आप ओल्ड सिलेबस से न्यू सिलेबस में आ रहे हैं तो आपको 1000 रुपये पे करना होता है. एक लिंक जो है इंस्टीट्यूट ने दिया है, जिस का लिंक जो है मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन में दे दूंगा. वहां से जाकर आपको डायरेक्टली पेमेंट करना होता है इंस्टीट्यूट की वेबसाइट पे, एंड देन आपका जो एक्सेस है वो आपको ई लर्निंग पोर्टल में मिल जाता है. अब ई लर्निंग पोर्टल क्या है उसकी डिटेल्स मैं ऑलरेडी बहुत सारे बना चुका हूँ. इफ यू हैव क्लियर योर ODOP, सो यू नो द प्रोसेस हाउ यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर ODOP विद द सेम वे लाइक यू नीड टू लॉग इन विद द ई लर्निंग पोर्टल. जस्ट लॉग इन योर स्मैश ID एंड पासवर्ड. Follow the description on the screen. Okay, then after logging your account, you will able to see the my course option. Click on that, and you need to find out my course option. Then you will able to see pre-test option once you have completed your fee payment. Okay, otherwise if you are new registered with ICSI, so you don't need to give another 1000 rupees because you have already given this pre-test fee at the time of registration in executive program. Okay, so this is the basically fundamental things to complete your pre-test. Now we are talking about the mode that the pattern and other related details of pre-examination test. So first of all, this is the online computer course. Student can take test from home, cyber cafe, any other location. And if you do not have any laptop or system at your home, you can buy, you can ask from your friend. So it has a multiple choice question MCQ type with negative marking of 25% of allocated marks. Alright, the result of the test will be available immediately on completion of your test. Once you complete your test, the result will be there immediately. जब आप अपना रिजल्ट कंप्लीट अपना एग्जाम कंप्लीट कर लेंगे तो रिजल्ट अब भी आपके सामने इमिडिएटली शो कर देगा जैसे ही आप कंप्लीट करते हैं. रिजल्ट ऑफ द टेस्ट वुड बी लिंक्ड विद द एनरोलमेंट प्रोसेस ऑफ द एग्जामिनेशन. ऑलराइट, द क्वेश्चन विल बी कैटेगराइज एज पर द 3 डिफिकल्ट लेवल, इजी, मीडियम एंड टफ. शैल बी रेशियो 30, 40 एंड 30 इन ऑल ओवरऑल स्कीम. ऑलराइट, the process I told you that if you are old student, you need to first of all pay the fee of 1000 rupees, then only you will able to access in the e-learning portal, and just I told you how could you access for the same. All right, now we talk about some FAQs that I have been grant exemption in certain paper on basis of higher qualification, corresponding exemption on the basis of switchover, and I understand that I am not required to pre-test for the set papers or subject, kindly clarify. Alright, so suppose that you have get some exemption on the basis of switch over. Once you switch over, so you got some exemption in some paper, either you got exemption in higher qualification, basis on the higher qualification, so do you require to complete pre-test? Okay, so institute said that you might have grant exemption, paper wise exemption in some paper on the basis of higher qualification, either switch over. Okay, so for that what you need to do, just log in your account, click on the test of such paper, after that click on the I have read, understood and I already to begin, and directly you will able to see, use the exemption stuff or subject only after completing your 4-ed process, the respectively paper shall be marked as passed for issue pre-exemption test. Okay, so if you have got any exemption, you just follow the same process, you will able to see how many subject have been clear in pre-test basically. Okay, so you don't need to give the exam, the pre-test for those certain paper. Okay, next question, what will be the qualifying marks for each paper? So the subject wise qualifying mark will be minimum 40%. You at least gain 40% marks in your pre-test. Okay, next question, that I'm planning to appear for one module in executive program during ensuring session of examination, am I required to complete pre-test for the module 2? Okay, so suppose that you have failed the module 1 in any session you are going to give the module 1, and the question is that are you required to complete pre-test for the module 2 or not. ओके अगर आपने ऑलरेडी मॉड्यूल 1 का एग्जाम देने वाले हैं, आप क्वेश्चन ये है दैट कि आपको मॉड्यूल 2 का भी जो है प्री टेस्ट देना पड़ेगा कि नहीं. ठीक है, सो इंस्टीट्यूट सेड नो यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्लीट द प्री टेस्ट फॉर सब्जेक्ट कवर अंडर मॉड्यूल 1 ओनली. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट आर रिक्वायर्ड टू सक्सेसफुली कंप्लीट प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट ऑल सब्जेक्ट फॉर्मिंग पार्ट ऑफ स्पेसिफिक मॉड्यूल इन विच दे आर प्लानिंग टू अपियर द मेन एग्जामिनेशन. They may complete the pre-examination test in remaining module separately before seeking enrollment examination of such that particular second module or another module which you are not giving right now. Okay, so whenever you are giving to the second module, third module, if we talk about the professional program, whenever you are supposed to give, that time before enrolling, before filling your examination form, you need to complete this pre-test only. Okay, so can I complete pre-examination test after enrolling and appearing in main examination? Okay, क्या आप जो है अपना जो pre-test है before examination form fill up से पहले कर सकते हैं या नहीं? So this is the old guidelines that students are required to complete the pre-examination test before enrolling the main examination. But due to some circumstances, due to this COVID-19 as well, institute has given the option that before sitting the examination you can complete your pre-test, or also the institute has extend your validity, extend the timeline, the date for the same, that is 31st of July 4 p.m. so you could complete your examination, this pre-examination, till 31st July 4 p.m. if you have not completed yet. Okay, previous guidelines was there that without complete this pre-test you cannot fill the examination form as well. Okay, next question, I have successfully completed pre-examination test before seeking enrollment to previous session of examination, will it be valid for future session if I fail in the main examination? Suppose that you have already completed your pre-examination test, but whenever you are going for a module 1, 2, 3 or any module, you failed, you have not cleared your particular program, so will you need to do the pre-examination test again? अगर आपका जो है ऑलरेडी पे एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट कंप्लीट हो चुका है तो क्या आपको दोबारा देना पड़ेगा? सिंपल सही मान के चले. सो इंस्टीट्यूट सेड दैट प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट विल बी वैलिड फॉर द फ्यूचर सेशन ऑफ एग्जामिनेशन फॉर द रिस्पेक्टिव सब्जेक्ट. ओके, स्टूडेंट विल नॉट हैव टू क्लियर प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट ईच टाइम दे आर सीकिंग फॉर एनरोलमेंट फॉर मेन एग्जामिनेशन. सो अगर आपका एक बार ऑलरेडी प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट कंप्लीट हो चुका है, सो यू डोंट नीड टू डू, आपको दोबारा करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन चले, एम आई रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमिट एनी फी ऑफ अपेयरिंग प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट? सो यस, एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट इफ यू आर फ्रॉम ओल्ड सिलेबस टू द न्यू सिलेबस, यू नीड टू pay the fee of 1,000 rupee. Either if you are a fresh student where you have already given your 1,000 rupee for pre-test, so in that case you don't need. Next question chale that I have enrolled myself for classroom teaching conducted by the regional chapter office institute in my city. Shall I be exempt from appearing pre-examination test if I pass the test conducted by the said regional chapter officer after completing the classroom teaching session? Okay, so there is an option where you can complete the classroom teaching, and in that classroom teaching they also conduct the pre-examination test. So here the question that if you have already completed that pre-examination test, so can that pre-examination test will be exempt for you which is on the line. ओके अगर आपने क्लासरूम टीचिंग में जो है क्लासरूम जो टीचिंग होती है उसमें जो प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट होता है उसमें पास आउट किया है तो क्या आपके लिए ऑनलाइन वाला जो एग्जामिनेशन है वो एग्जाम होगा कि नहीं होगा. सो ये इंस्टीट्यूट सेड यस इंस्टीट्यूट स्टूडेंट हु हैव क्लियर द ऑफलाइन प्री टेस्ट इन स्पेसिफिक सब्जेक्ट आफ्टर undergoing classroom teaching session in regional and chapter office shall be exempt from the specific subject on online pre-examination test. Okay, so if you have already cleared your pre-examination test on in the classroom teaching session, so you don't need to give the online pre-examination test, it will be exempt for you. All right, next question, if we talk about the marks scores in the pre-examination test will be considered to computing in the result of main examination. So can this pre-examination test mark will be included in the main examination? So institute said no, pre-examination test will be qualifying test to assess the level of preparation of a student before appearing in the main exam. It's just a qualifying test. Okay, this marks will not be included to the main examination. Next question is that in case I fail the pre-examination test, shall I be given another opportunity to appear in pre-examination test? ओके अगर आप एक बार जो है प्री एग्जाम टेस्ट पास नहीं कर पाते हैं फेल हो जाते हैं सो क्या आपको दोबारा अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलेगी. सो इंस्टीट्यूट सेड स्टूडेंट मे अपेयर इन प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट एनीवेयर एंड नंबर एन नंबर ऑफ द टाइम्स आफ्टर रिसीविंग लॉगिन क्रेडेंशियल बट दे शैल बी अवेल टू अपेयर इन प्री एग्जामिनेशन टेस्ट ओनली वंस इन अ डे एंड द सेकेंड अटेम्प्ट कैन बी ओनली मेड आफ्टर 8 hours. ओके If the student close the browser by mistake, it will take 70 seconds to launch depending on internet connectivity. Further, student shall try to clear pre-test will be before his or her due date the filling the main examination form avoiding closing a day's rest. Okay, so you have n number of option to clear your pre-examination test if you do not clear your pre-examination test by 1, 2, 3 time. Okay, you have n number of time, but in a day you can do by as a institute said by one time only, and the second attempt can be made after 8 hours or 480 minutes after. So I hope I have cleared all your confusion which was running in your head. If you still have any questions, you can comment or below this video. I definitely reply you on that, and you can connect to me over Insta as well. My Insta handle is in the description box. You can go and connect to me. So if you like this video, so hit the like button, share with your friend who is still in the confusion for the pre-test. If you want to know more about the CS and wants to do update from the ICSI very fast, so you need to subscribe and click on the bell icon, and I'll see you in the next video. Till that time, very thank you for your.